In an age of government cutbacks, ambitious plans for space exploration are often little more than animated videos of what missions might look like. But this is part of the Orion project in the flesh, a NASA space program that aims to take astronauts on a mission to fly past Mars and Venus. The first test flight is due later this year with a manned mission schedule for 2021, and the Kennedy Space Center is at the heart of operations.
These series of flights we've got coming up, we're really returning to space and returning humans to deep space where we haven't been in 40 years, which is pretty exciting to be a part of that.
But the days of solely government-funded space programs are gone, and you could be fooled into thinking that for the next few years this famous site of historic missions will be quiet.
When the space shuttle program ended, many hailed it as the end of a golden age of space exploration. But already private companies are vying for new contracts here, and they have ambitious plans to take space travel into a new era.
Three companies working.
That new era is a partnership between the US government and a commercial sector keen to cash in on space exploration. In many ways, this is a renaissance in space travel built on Florida's legacy. But executives say the Cape will have plenty of competition.
Other states, just like other nations, are going to seek space activity, and that includes both vertical and horizontal launch. So Florida will not be alone, and that reference is not to alien beings, it'll be to competition from other states.
Atlas V, but here in Florida, there's no shortage of potential customers for those developing space tourism.
I would absolutely do it. I think that it would be amazing to be up there.
Because it's like an adventure when you go into space and you get to see like moon rocks and stuff.
What about you?
Because you get to float up in gravity.
The foundations of a new space industry are taking shape across the world, and competition will be fierce. Those backing the Space Coast in Florida say it's already ahead of the rest, meaning this could be the last stop before leaving the planet. Andy Gallagher, Al Jazeera, Cape Canaveral, Florida.